Hello and welcome back to App for You. So in this particular video, I will be discussing about the code of the, you know, the cycle detection in the linked list, right? So in the previous video, we had discussed two techniques of basically detecting a loop in the linked list. So the very efficient approach was found to be using the Floyd algorithm, right? Floyd algorithm is nothing but basically here what we do is Floyd algorithm of cycle detection, where we use the concept of two pointers, one moving at a slow pace, very slow speed, and other moving at a very faster speed, right? Or basically the tortoise and hare concept, right? We also discussed how actually this particular problem works. So let me just quickly go through the problem and then I'll just jump into the coding part. So basically, we have discussed that as per this particular Floyd algorithm for cycle detection, what we basically do is, initially, we have two pointers, slow pointer and fast pointer, both points towards points to the head node, alright? Both points to the starting node, head node. And now what we do is, we make this slow pointer moves one node at each step, okay? At each iteration, the slow pointer will take one step, whereas the fast pointer will actually take two iteration at each iteration, at two step at each iteration. What I mean is basically, you see, slow pointer took one step, and fast pointer takes one and two steps, right? So fast pointer reaches here, slow pointer reaches here. So this is after one iteration. What after second iteration? So in the second iteration, what will happen? Slow pointer will now come here, and faster pointer will come one and two. So basically fast pointer will arrive here. You can see fast pointer has arrived here and slow pointer has arrived here, right? One jump. So basically slow pointer is taking one jump at each step and the fast pointer is taking two jump at each iteration, right? So one jump at each iteration and two jump at each iteration respectively. Now again, in the fourth iteration, what will happen? The slow pointer will come here. So you can see slow pointer has come here because it has taken one jump, whereas the fast pointer should come here. So it has already come here, right? Now what about the fifth iteration? So basically what is the status at the fourth iteration? The slow pointer is here and fifth iteration and the fast pointer is here, right? So in the fifth iteration, what happens? The slow pointer comes here, right? So let me use the pen. The slow pointer comes here, the fast pointer comes one and two here, right? What after the sixth iteration? So after the sixth iteration, you will find that the slow pointer has come here and the fast pointer has taken its position. So basically slow pointer comes here and the fast pointer has taken this position. So you can see fast pointer has taken the position. What after the seventh iteration? So in the seventh iteration, finally you will find that the slow pointer reaches here because it has taken one jump. What about the fast pointer? Fast pointer will also point towards the same node. So this is the case where both have met. So assuming that SP indicates the tortoise, right? The one who moves one step or one node at each iteration, and the fast pointer indicates the turtle, or indicates the rare, right, or the rabbit, taking double jumps at each iteration. So basically, as per the Floyd cycle detection algorithm, the concept is that if a tortoise and a rare have started a race, okay, in a track, okay, where the speed of the tortoise is twice that of the turtle, okay, where the speed of the rare or the rabbit is twice of that of the turtle, okay, so speed of the rabbit or the rare is twice of that of the turtle. So in this case, what will happen if there is a loop in the linked list? Then there will be some point in the loop where both will meet. Getting the point? So since these two are moving at different speeds, right, because the speed of rabbit is greater than the speed of tortoise, so they will meet only if there is a loop, right? Because if they are moving in a straight line, then they will never meet because the rabbit or the rare will be very far away from the tortoise. But in case they are moving in a circular loop, this is only the possibility when they are moving at different speed and they will meet at a certain point inside the loop, okay? So the concept in simple words is that the tortoise and the rabbit, okay, the tortoise and the rabbit, where the rabbit is moving two steps, okay, at each iteration, and the tortoise is taking single step at each iteration, means they are moving at different speed. One is slow, one is fast. So if they are moving in a straight line, they will never meet, obvious. So basically, if they have met somehow, it indicates that the circuit is, it indicates that the track is circular in nature. In other words, there is a circuit in the linked list, right? So you can see there is a cycle in the linked list, and hence they have met, right? Because they are moving at two different speeds. And they will be meet only if they are moving in a cycle. So basically, if there is a cycle, only then they will meet at certain point. So this is how the concept actually worked of two pointers. So this was the concept of the slow pointer and the fast pointer, or you can say the tortoise and the rare concept, right? So can we code this? So obviously, let me take you to the coding section. So basically, I have opened the Geek for Geeks question here. So basically, if you see this particular problem, I have just solved it. So this is us done in C++, alright. So you see what happens is now you just have to code the important part, right? This particular function I was asked to code. You don't have to code anything else. You just have to code in this particular block. The remaining thing is is already present there, because the node is already defined, the linked list is already defined, cycle is already defined. You just have to, you know, write the main function to detect the loop. So very simple words, very simple to explain. You see what I have done here. Basically, I am receiving the head pointer, right? I am receiving the address of the head. Okay, once I receive the address of the head, I know where is the head node. Now basically the first concept is slow pointer and fast pointer both should point towards head, right? So I have written that. Next, I know I have to use a while loop which will say check whether the fast pointer is pointing to some node or not, valid node or not, or whether it is null, right? Because if it is null, it indicates that there are no nodes further, right? So the fast pointer and the node next to fast pointer both should be null, right? Because I have to take two jumps. So basically the fast pointer and the next pointer next to fast pointer node means the fast pointer and the node where the fast to next pointer is pointing should be non-null, means there should be some nodes. Only then this process will work. I'll get in. What will I do? Slow pointer takes one step, can see, and fast pointer is taking two steps, right? And in case I found that the slow pointer and fast pointer is pointing towards the same node, it indicates that yes, this is the point where I have detected the cycle, right? Means the cycle is present here. That is why they have met at such point. Now, if the entire loop is traversed and never this condition was executed, it indicates that there was no cycle in the linked list, right? So finally, what will we do? If this was never executed, finally you will come out of the loop and you will return false, which indicates that there is no cycle in the loop. So basically, I had just compiled this, right? So you see, a very faster approach, order n, isn't it? Because it is taking 0.13. But you cannot compare the time complexity with this execution time, right? It's completely different concept, because time complexity always is defined in terms of the how the algorithm is varying with the respect of the input, number of inputs, n, right? And this execution time is architecture dependent, system dependent. So we don't compare this with this, but you can see it is a faster approach because it is taking order n, and space complexity is order 1, right? Because I haven't used any extra space, right? So that's how it works. So basically, if you want me to run this again, then you can see this is compilation done. So yes, ready for evaluation. All right, so that's it from my side. Let's submit the code. Yeah, 0.12, it's fine. So I hope you liked this video. This video was intuitive. In case of any doubts and queries, please post your doubt in the comment section. Keep watching, app for you. Thank you.